Do you have a van like this, and do you want to put the spare tire under that, and you don't know how to install the mechanism? I'm going to show you step by step how you can do that. This is a regular six side, so we're going to put it here. It's a hex, and as you can see, it's pretty close, but in this case, it's a 3/8, as you can see over there. And I'm ready to weld, so and let's see how it goes. Was a success. So once you have it there, as you can see, if you unscrew it, it will release more the cable, and if you screw it for the other side, it goes up. So it works like a champ. Now I'm going to unscrew it. I'm going to put the tire, and let's see how it goes. All right, as you can see, in order to remove this, you will have to take the tire out as much as you can. It seems like this is too tight. I mean, it barely fits. I'll show you in a little bit, but this is how it goes. So this part that you see here goes on top of this, and this goes under that. So you have to put it like that, as much as possible. There you go. And then you will have to put the, move it until you can grab, you can leave this end on top of that, as you can see here. And after that, you should be able to pull this. I mean, as you can see, it's falling. I don't know if you can put some kind of nut over here, or it's like that, but as far as I can tell, it's look like this is the way it's going to be. So if I try to put it in another hole, maybe a little bit better, but I don't like this system that much. So as you can see, it barely fits my hand like that. So I'll see if I can push it and I can lift it up with this, or if I have to lift up the whole van more or what. Or maybe I need a slimmer tire, but this is crazy. As you can see, I have more space now, and it's way inside of the car. So as you can see, hopefully you can see this night over there. So you can see over there, and now it's in position. So the trick that I had to do in order to solve this, I had to use the car shack, as you can see. And I was able to lift it up. I mean, I have maybe 500 pounds in tools, so that is why the van is very low. That is what I'm guessing. And otherwise, I had to remove the hitch, but I don't want to remove the hitch. I use it though very often to pull my trailer that I have over there. So Now I have to do the trick. Now I put it back again, pull the trigger, and it should go up all the way. I'll show you. Right, I made a little mistake, so the tire have to be in the other side facing the floor, because otherwise it was not going to be very tight. So now we should do the same and everything should be good. As you can see, it's looking great. So the only thing, that hook that you see over there is not going on top of this. So the bad thing is that it's in like not going. Come on. Oh, there we go. As you can see, I was able to put the hook on top of this. So now we should be able to move it under the car. I should be able to pull it and we should be good. It's perfectly in the middle. So that way, when you start spinning with the impact driver, everything should be good. So let's try again. As you can see, this seems to be firm enough. Maybe I can tight it a little bit more, but it's great. So now I can remove the car jack and that's it.